Hi everyone, and welcome to the second lesson in the series on English grammar. My name is Oliver, or you can call me Ollie for short, and I will be your instructor for this course. So, guys, today we are going to learn about pronouns in the English language. In addition to that, we're also going to take a look at the verbs to have and to be. To have and to be are the two most commonly used verbs in the English language. In addition to all of this, we're also going to take a look at some new nouns and adjectives in the English language as well. So first, let's take a look at the most commonly used pronouns in English. I, okay, I. We use I to talk about ourselves. I am Oliver, okay, I. I also sounds like somebody's I, okay? It's spelt a little bit differently. It's spelt E-Y-E. I, so one eye, two eyes, okay? I. Next we have you, okay? You, okay? You, we use to talk about one person, or you can use you to talk about more than one person. You can use you to talk about three people, or four people, or five people, or even a group of people. Okay? We say you. You also sounds like the letter U. Okay? The letter U in English. You. Next we have he. He. Okay? We have H. It's aspirated. He. Okay, he is used for boys. Okay, he is used for boys. Then we have she with an S. She, and she is used for girls. We only use he when talking about one boy, and we only use she when talking about one girl. Okay, next we have we. Okay, we, and we is basically I and you together. So I plus you. Okay, and that's we. We. Finally, we have they. They is similar to he and she. It refers to people, you know, they. But it refers to not one person, it refers to more than one person. So two, three, four, five people. Okay, so it refers to more than one person. We say they, okay? And they can be used for both boys, and it can be used for girls as well. So you can choose. We also have another pronoun in the English language, guys. The pronoun is it. Okay, I'll write it right here at the bottom. It's it, okay? It. Now, we use it to talk about things that do not have gender, okay? In other languages, such as French and Spanish and Italian, there exists something called gender, meaning nouns are attributed a certain quality, either masculine or feminine. In English, we do not have that. So it is used for things such as animals, okay, like cats, right, or dogs, or it can also be used with other nouns such as places, like a city like San Francisco, or the country of Canada, or other places. It, okay, it is a nice place, okay? So again, I, you, he, she, we, they, and it. Now remember, it is used for nouns that do not have gender. If we're talking about people, we have to use he and she. In all other cases, we use it. Okay? Let's go ahead and continue, guys. So these are the pronouns in English. Now let's move on to verbs. Okay? Our first verb is the verb to have. Let's go ahead and conjugate the verb to have. To conjugate the verb to have, we have I, and then we're going to write I have, H-A-V-E. You have. He, she, and then we have it, okay? Because it is a lot like he and she in that it is the third person singular, okay? Okay, so we have he, she, it, has, we have, and they have. Okay, again, I have, you have, he has, she has, it has, we have, they have. Okay? Also, make sure that you notice that there is only one change in the conjugation of the verb to have, and it's found in the third person singular, has, with an S. Okay? He, she, it, has. All right? Now let's look at the verb to be. In English, the verb to be is the most commonly used verb in the English language. And we use this in all sorts of tenses. It has an irregular conjugation in both the present tense and in the past tense. Let's look at it. It is I am, A-M, I am. I am Oliver. My name is Oliver. I am Oliver. I am a boy. Okay, you are, A-R-E, you are, okay, you are a student, you are a boy, you are a girl, he, she, it, is, okay, he is a boy, she is a girl, it is a cat, okay, then we have we, okay, we, okay, we are boys. Okay, we are boys, or you could say we are girls. And finally, we have they, okay, they. You can say they are, okay, they are. All right, one more time. I am, so I am a teacher, for example. You are a student. He is tall. She is short. It is cute. Okay? It is cute, right? We are American. Okay? Or we are, you know, human. Okay? We belong to the planet Earth. We are human. They are Canadian. They are French. They are tall. They are short. They are boys. They are girls. Okay? So, guys, just remember that to be is an irregular verb in both the present tense and in the past tense. Okay? Now, you have to memorize this and remember that in the first person, and in the third person, there is a difference. We say I am and he, she, it is. Now let's make some sentences using the personal pronouns and the verbs that we just learned. The verb to have and the verb to be. And we're also going to learn some new nouns and adjectives as well. So just remember the structure for the verb to have, okay? First, you need to have a pronoun and then a verb and lastly a noun. So pronoun, verb, noun. Okay, let's look at some examples. It says, I have a cold. Okay, so I have a cold. Okay, so what is a cold? What is a cold? A cold can mean the temperature. Okay, so oftentimes when the temperature is cold, it's like, you know, the temperature is very cold, whereas up here it's very, very hot. When you come up here, it's very, very hot, cold. But it can also mean somebody is sick. Like when you have a cold, you're coughing. Or when you have a cold, you're sneezing. Achoo! Okay, so a cold, it's like, okay, he's coughing, he's sneezing. So I have a cold. Next we have he blank an orange. What can we say? He has. has an orange. Okay? She has oranges. Okay? Notice we have an S. It's plural. Here we don't have an S. Okay? There's no S, but we have an, which is an indefinite article, and we use and because there's an N here, and this is an O. Okay? And remember, we do this with A, E, I, O, and U. Then we have they. They have the books. They have. Okay? So again, let's read it. I have a cold. Achoo! He has oranges. He has an orange. She has oranges. And finally, they have the books. And you know what books are. You read books. Okay? You read books. All right. So now we have a few different ones here that we're going to be using with the verb to be. Okay, so here we have the verb to have, and here we're going to use the verb to be. Okay, let's look. So, first it says, do you know what we can use? I am. I am sleepy, okay? You know what sleepy means? Sleepy, okay? You're very tired. Oh. I'm sleepy. Okay, sleepy, we say. Sleepy. Next we have you are, okay, are. You are sad, okay? You are sad. We, me and you, we are happy, okay? We are happy. And finally, they are angry, okay? They are angry, okay? I'm angry, okay? Sometimes you'll hear another word. Sometimes you'll hear the word upset. Oops. Here, I'll write it again. Sorry. U-P-S-E-T. Upset. They are angry. They are upset. Okay, so you can use whichever one you want. Remember, I am sleepy, you are sad, we are happy, and they are angry. All right, guys? So that's it for this lesson today, and I just want to say thank you so much for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time in the next lesson, lesson number 3. Okay? Take care. See you next time. Bye.